out your engines for a Sony Computer Entertainment America production. Fasten your seatbelts for another Naughty Dog creation.
What's up, my pilots? Angryponcho here, and welcome to Let's Play Crash Team Racing. So the game is a little bit weird. It has this intro cutscene that only plays if you hang out at the main menu for a little while. So I'm gonna hang out at the main menu for a little while. This game is a childhood memory for me. Here we go. Now we're getting a cutscene. If you just click New Adventure, it puts you right into the game. You don't get this cutscene. It's really weird. Race today.
Greetings, creatures of this world. I come to compete. So, you pesky Earth slugs like to race, eh? Well, I, Nitrous Oxide, I'm the fastest racer in the galaxy. I travel the stars looking for creatures to test my skills. It's a little game I call Survival of the Fastest. Here's the way we play. I challenge the best driver of your world to a race for the planet. If your driver wins, I'll leave your miserable little rock alone. But if I win, I'll turn your entire globe into a concrete parking lot and make you my slaves.
Le gasp.
Get ready to race for the fate of your planet.
Wow, wow, wow.
She used computer chips to make her car faster. Oh, man. Oh, wow. This game is pretty fun. I gotta say, it is a childhood memory for me. And part of that is because I never had any of the early Nintendo consoles, like a SNES or an N64. So I never played the original Mario Kart or Mario Kart 64. So this was my Mario Kart. And those of you who played Mario Kart will probably realize that there's a lot of parallels between the two games. This game definitely just decided to do a Mario Kart clone with its own plot and its own cast of characters from the Sony franchises. But I like it a lot, and I think it's a good game that stands up pretty well on its own. So, and it's hella fun. I mean, even today it's pretty easy, but it's still hella fun. So I'm gonna play as Crash, of course, partly because he's got let me actually show you the other kart stats, because you're not gonna know offhand. Can I get over to the cancel button, please? No, I was there for a second. Okay. So you got Crash, and then you got, of course, Neocortex, the villain of the Crash series. They're both balanced racers, speed, acceleration, and turning. Then you got Tiny Tiger and, where's Dingodile? There's Dingodile, who have high speed karts and poor turning. Then there's Coco, Crash's sister, who's got the better acceleration. And InGen also for that setup. Coming around over here, we have the two animals, the two cute little animals that have an emphasis on turning capability. Of course, Crash is the best kart. I mean, it depends on your playstyle, really, but I prefer Crash. Punch. Actually, let's go Poncho, shall we? Oh, yeah. I'm gonna overwrite this file that just says A. All right. So we know what's at stake. This is going to be pretty freaking sweet. This is a fun game. And it's going to go pretty quickly early on, I think, but you know.
Welcome to the Adventure Arena. You can travel around this area and practice your driving skills. The dots and stars on the map represent warp pads, which lead to races. When they flash, it signifies they are open to play. To access a racetrack, drive onto a warp pad that has an active warp vortex, and it will take you to the track start line. Finish a track in first place to win a trophy. As you collect more trophies, other tracks will turn on and open to you. Good luck, and drive fast.
I'd normally skip tutorials, but I wanted you to be introduced to Aku Aku if you have never played a Crash Bandicoot game before. And I was going to have to explain that thing about the trophies anyway, because that's how you progress through the game, is collecting them. So you gotta win first place. Simple enough, right? And of course, the first few races are really easy. So it'll just give me an opportunity to demonstrate the various ways that you can win in these games. So at the very beginning of the race there, you actually can get a boost if you hit the acceleration button, which is X, typically, right before the race starts, basically. You have to time it just right so that you your little meter in the bottom right is full up when the race starts. And that gives you a boost. This track is pretty much as simple as they get. It's just a big loop. There's nothing too complicated in it. The only tricky part is the second turn, I guess it would be. Oh, I totally missed that. I thought it was farther to the left. Oh well. I'm not even doing any of the advanced techniques. You can just drive and you'll be faster than most of the people on this first level. They make it pretty easy. You can also bounce up here to get an extra item cart and avoid having to go underneath that dock. But that's a little bit trickier. Some of those jumps can be really difficult to make. In fact, there's several of them in this game that are complicated. I'm gonna go up here just because I can, to show you all the places you can take. There's another item box up here if you decide you need that. Okay, so there's a lot of items in this game too, and rather than kind of explaining them all at once, I'm just gonna explain them as I happen to get them. So, oh, there's a bomb coming after me. So this thing that's on my head right now is, that's around my cart, is a blue shield. So basically, oops, I thought that would break that thing a little sooner. Damn. This might actually be a race to the finish. So you have these Wampa fruit in the boxes that don't have question marks. The question mark boxes, of course, have items in them. Easy enough. I guess I'll just explain the items as I get to them. There's a whole bunch of them, and there's two tiers. So with the Wampa fruit, what they're for is if you have less than 10, you get the weaker tier of items. But if you have 10 Wampa fruit, if you're full up, then you get the stronger version of the item. So basically, you want to collect those Wampa fruit and hang on to them. And then you... Ingen has a rocket stuck in his head, apparently. It's crazy. Congratulations. So you want to get the Wampa fruit and then hang on to them so you can get the better items.
The more Wampa fruit you collect, the faster your cart will go.
Also does that.
If you collect and hold 10 Wampa fruit, you'll be juiced up, and your power-up will become more potent.
Ooh, I'm plenty potent. Thank you very much, Aku Aku. Yeah, so that's basically what they're for. It's just like Mario Kart. When in doubt, refer to Mario Kart. It actually even does the thing where it makes you faster. So this is Ruse Tubes, the second track. Traditionally, there's no actual order. I could have gone straight over to the next one, but this is just the order they are and how close they are to where you start. This is actually the level where you race this area's boss. So the way the whole game is set up is you have four areas, and each area has a boss. The bosses are typically really fast carts that just, oh great, I got an Aku Aku. Sweet. It's the best item, pretty much. If you run into somebody with this item, they get spun out, and it also makes you hyper fast. It's pretty sweet. And then you got those little turbo things you can get as well. Yeah, so there's a lot in this game that's parallel. So here we go. Get my 10 Wampa fruit. Be faster. So yeah, as I was saying, the bosses, they typically have two things going for them. One, they're ridiculously fast. Haha, I hit his rocket with my nitro box, whatever it's called, crate. bosses are really fast, and they also have what seems to be an unlimited amount of one of the items. So, I'll explain it when we get to the first boss, which will probably be in the next episode. Whoops, took that turn all wrong. There we go. Yeah, so the bosses can be really difficult, but most of the other races are fairly easy. There are a few tracks that come to mind as being more difficult than the rest, but they're few and far between, honestly. It's a relatively simple and easy game, which you would expect. It's a game for kids. So this is, of course, and I haven't mentioned it, but the intro probably made it clear, this is a game on the original PlayStation. So this is what I played in my childhood, because that's what I had, was the original PlayStation. Yeah, we're probably going to be able to play a lot of races in this first episode, because they're so short at the beginning. The tracks do get longer, and they do get more difficult. Particularly the bosses. The second boss, I remember being a huge pain. Oh, the other thing the bosses have going for them is they have massive slingshot AI. You pass them, they will almost immediately pass you right back. So the only way to win on a boss is to wait until the very end of the race and pass them just before the finish line. Otherwise, they'll blow right by you again.
You win a trophy. When you get a TNT crate on your head, start hopping immediately. If you react fast and hop enough times, the TNT crate will fall off your head before it explodes.
Good advice. Don't let TNT crates explode on your head. Got it. Yeah, so you need to win the third race before you can unlock that. Whoops. Race there. What's this?
This is the load save screen.
Thanks.
There are five.
Got it. Yeah, you can just save your game there. It's a big old giant computer screen in the game. And there's a door over here.
You must have two boss keys to open this door.
Alrighty. Just getting the good part and then skipping the rest of the tutorials. Not exciting. Mystery caves. So which one is this? Ah, this isn't a very exciting level either. This one's pretty easy, but it has the first example of where you're supposed to figure out that jumping helps you. Basically, in this game, anytime you land after taking some air, you get a boost. That's pretty good. So that's what you want to go for, is anytime there's something that you can get a nice hop off of, you want to go for that. It's going to increase your speed when you land. I don't know why, it doesn't really make any sense, but if you can get mad air, you will be faster. That's definitely to your advantage to be going for every jump you can spot. I'm going to get burned. Oh no, I was right behind it. So this is fun. It's got the flames that go up and down. Pretty easy to avoid, honestly. Just go to whatever side there's not going to be a flame on when you get there. All you have to do is tell the future. Yeah, so you can see the speed boost that you get from those those little jumps. It's pretty fun, actually, to get those little hops. So the way that the gimmick in this track is that those things alternate which one is a good jump and which one is a low jump. So see, that was crummy. That was a waste of my time right there. Whereas the other one would have given me some more air and I would have actually been able to do something with it. I'll try and get over there. Yeah, like that. It's fun, too. Taking those jumps is awesome. Oh, I let go of the item just a second too late. I like to drop my potions right in front of the other item boxes just to mess with people. So there's two tiers of potions. There's a green one and a red one. There's a green one there. And the green one is the weak one. It just spins you out like a banana peel. Try to avoid unnecessary Mario Kart references, but that's the best way to explain it. And then the red one actually puts a stormy day cloud over your head, and it slows you down for an extended period. Whoa, almost got hit by what might have been my own potion. Yep. So the red ones really blow because they slow you down for a long period. So the TNT crates that he mentioned, that Aku mentioned before this race, are a cool item. They're really annoying because once you get one on your head, you have to hit the R1 button over and over again to hop like this. And if you do it well enough, the crate will fall off before it explodes. You have to do it a certain number of hops. I forget. You basically just keep going until it falls off or until it blows up. Look at all the stuff in the middle of the track. I've left all three of those there, and nobody's hit one of them yet. I don't know what path they're taking through that turn, but they're not going the way it's fastest. Yeah, so then the better version of the TNT crates, they just explode right when you hit them. So you... yeah. Look at the consistency in those lap times. Wow. So the nitro crates, the green crates, they blow up right when you hit them. So it's a better item than the TNT crate, which you can just knock right off of your head with a little hopping. So as I never finished saying, the game is broken up into four areas. Each area has four races and a boss. And then once you've beaten all four bosses, you can go fight the final boss. Basically, it's that simple.
Congratulations, you win a trophy. You can get a hang time turbo from jumping. The longer you're in the air, the bigger the turbo you'll get when you land. For big turbos, try to get extra air time by hopping off jumps using the R1 button.
Yep, that's how you get the springy action that actually gets you enough air to get anything out of it. Otherwise, you'll never make it enough of anything. Alright, Sewer Speedway. This is, other than that little shortcut I showed you in the very first level, this is the first level that has a significant, cool shortcut. Several levels in this game allow you to cheat enormously, taking shortcuts. This one's actually not that much shorter than the actual track, it's just really cool. There we go. That was a good boost. I always try and cut in between those two cars in right in front of you. I didn't get a boost on that jump. That was weird. Thought I would. So I'm going to go around the track collecting items and trying to get a speed boosting item, because that hole in the wall in front of me, which you may or may not have been able to spot, is the shortcut. Oops. I definitely wanted to get that item. And the only way to get up there is to have some sort of speed boost. You got to either have like full Wampa food and a good jump, or you need an item to make you go faster. I'm not getting anything that makes me go faster, I'm getting obstacles. But yeah, being the first cart to get 10 Wampa fruit, if you can get 10 Wampa fruit on the first lap, big advantage. All I'm getting is potions. I want a little boost cart or something. Whoops. Messed up that turn. So if you power slide through the corners, which I'm sure Aku would tell us about at some point, you can get 3 boosts per corner. And that gives you a lot of speed. Another red potion, are you serious? Man, I'll try it without, just to see. Yeah, not quite gonna make it unless you have some kind of speed boost item. Oh, I really need to get items. I can't be missing them. Will I make it? Barely. Yeah, so I like this level. It's got the first level with real obstacles and a real challenge to try and make that shortcut. Oh, come on, give me something that makes me drive faster. All I'm getting is red potions. I mean, they're good items, but not that great when you're this far ahead. It's littering that area with nitro crates. Ugh, I messed up that turn bad. Alright, I only have one more item box left to try and get this jump. Hopefully, I get something that makes me go faster. Could be an Aku Aku or a boost. Another red potion, are you serious right now, game? Nope. Well, that sucks. I got it on the first lap of my practice run. Nitro kart again! I need something to make me go faster! Alright, I'm gonna come back to this track and try and get that boost, because that's a cool shortcut. You just can't. It's really hard to make it, and whoops, I hit my own red rainy day potion. It's really cool. Yeah, and you can't. You don't get any new items while the cloud's over you, too. See how it's just flickering forever? Still way ahead. Forget how to exactly maximize the number of boosts yet. Yeah, so didn't get to show you the shortcut. I'll come back into that same track and take laps until I get an item that lets me get in there. Just because it's that cool. I just want to show it. I'm going to show all the shortcuts that I know. So that makes 4 tracks. If you've been keeping track you know what comes next. Are you crazy enough to race me? I'll show you wild driving. Last one across the finish line is a rotten brain. Okay, Rue, take it easy, buddy. I'm just gonna turn around. Oh, did they lock up all the tracks? It looks that way. Yeah, they did. Jeez, I have to race the boss now. Okay. Well, game, if you insist, I'll race Ripper Roo. Next time on Let's Play Crash Team Racing. Thanks for watching. See you guys then.